Symfony IOL, this is something completely different. I believe you have some experience with Symfony IOL. Back to numbers, so as I said before, around one-third of lenses that we implant in our clinic in Zagreb are presbyopia corrective lenses. So what do we implant? We implant trifocal lenses, you know, Zeiss AT LISA, Panoptix, Acriva Trinova. We implant them mostly in patients who are heavy readers, who likes to read a lot at near. And they're ready to accept lower quality of vision and some halo and glare, but they want to be free of glasses. The other option is Tecnis Symfony, extended range of vision, IOL. Also, combination of Tecnis Symfony and Tecnis Low ED in order to improve near vision. And Tecnis Synergy is the new lens that was launched in ECRS meeting in Paris in September. And as I learned, in Ukraine will be you will have opportunity to try it at the beginning of the next year. So we have multifocal and trifocal IOLs. We have accommodating IOLs that really do not function, and we have this new segment, EDOF, extended depth of focus intraocular lenses. Extended depth of focus intraocular lenses are lenses that have better contrast sensitivity, they have less halo and glare compared to multifocal lenses, but near vision is not so good like in multifocal lenses. So, Tecnis Symfony is a new concept. It has so-called HLA design. HLA is diffractive pattern which gives one focus but elongated. So this is not multifocal lens. This lens has one focus but elongated. It also has achromatic technology which corrects chromatic aberration, and this lens has excellent contrast sensitivity or quality of vision. So when you look at this lens, it looks like standard multifocal lens. But please remember, this is lens with extended depth of focus. It has only one focus, but it is extended from distance, from far, to intermediate and near. These rims shows this is diffractive lens, but not multifocal. So you're in Svetlost since July 2014, so in these 5 years, we implanted more than 1,500 Symfony intraocular lenses. We have experience in bilateral Symfony implantation. At the beginning, we targeted emmetropy in both eyes, like in trifocal lenses that we implanted before. And patients had excellent distant vision, excellent intermediate vision, very small rate of halo and glare, and some of them had problem with near vision. So what did we do? In this space, we decided to do some small myopic shift in non-dominant eye. In dominant eye, with Symfony, we target emmetropia. In non-dominant eye, small myopic shift up to -0.25, -0.3 to increase near vision. After that, we did combination of Symfony with Tecnis multifocal plus 2.75. I'm not sure that you are using it in Ukraine. It helped near vision. So you can use it in combination with monofocal lens in patients who had LASIK prior to the surgery, in amblyopic patients with mild maculopatia, glaucoma, dry eye, in high myopia. Very briefly, I give you some examples, some cases. So first one is my friend. He is 50 and something years old. He's engineer, and he was very. He wanted to be free of glasses, but he drives a lot. He travels a lot, and he drives a lot during the night. So I was waiting till Symfony came, and I said to him, "I have a lens which is good for you." So he was hyperop, clear lens extraction. I implanted Symfony to him, excellent distance visual acuity, excellent near visual acuity. He's a very tall guy with a long arm, so he can move a little bit when he's reading, and he doesn't wear glasses. He's very happy with very small rate of halos and glare. The other patient, she's a lawyer, 55 years old. She needs good visual acuity at computer, but she also has to read at near. And she said that she don't want to have any halo and glare. She was very scared of halo and glare. So I decided to implant Symfony in dominant eye and Tecnis plus bifocal plus 2.75 near addition in non-dominant eye. Excellent distant visual acuity with Symfony eye. She can read Jagger 2 to Jagger 3 with Tecnis Jagger 1, and with both eyes she is very happy and doesn't wear glasses. This is a patient, 50 years old, soldier. He had cataract surgery in other hospital with a monofocal IOL, very good visual acuity, some small myopic astigmatism, and he wanted to be free of glasses. He came to our clinic. I told him, well, you know, you have monofocal in one eye. I explained to him halo, possible glare, difference in two eyes, and he was ready to accept it, and we went with Symfony in the other eye. Excellent near, excellent distance visual acuity, very happy patient. Patients who had LASIK are very demanding patients because they already did one surgery in order to be free of glasses. Now they have cataract, they want to do cataract surgery and to be free of glasses again. So, with multifocal lenses, it's always the problem because of IOL calculation, status of the cornea, dryness of the eye. So you have some problems with Symfony. Symfony is more forgiving to any IOL calculation errors. It has better contrast sensitivity compared to multifocal lenses, better quality of vision. And it is less sensitive to syndrome of dry eye. So nowadays, we in patients who had LASIK, we implant only Symfony IOL. This is journalist, very important journalist, VIP patient in Croatia. He had LASIK in our institution. Now he was high myope. Now he has cataract. We implanted Symfony in both eyes. Excellent result. Very happy patient. This is his post LASIK cornea. This is lady from Slovenia. She had LASIK in other institution in Slovenia, and now she has cataract on right eye. I implanted Symfony toric, excellent distant visual acuity. It finished some small hyperopic shift because it is very important to have good IOL calculation. But she is happy and she will do the other eye probably next year. This is her topography prior to surgery. In amblyopic eye, look at this lady. She has plus 3 in right eye, 2.5 left eye. She works a lot at computer. She was very, very highly motivated to be free of glasses. I told her that I don't promise freedom of the glasses. We did Symfony in both eyes. She's very happy. She works a lot at computer and she almost never uses glasses. This is a patient from Slovenia with small epiretinal membrane, very motivated. He plays golf a lot. He wants to be free of glasses so he can play golf, he can see on his cell phone. So I told him that he's not a perfect patient because of right eye, but we implanted Symfony. Small residual astigmatism, near vision pretty good, left eye perfect. Since this surgery was 3 years ago, he's still stable and very happy patient. This is mother-in-law of one of our employees. So all men know that mother-in-law is very VIP patient, very important patient. So she came to our clinic with some degree of macular degeneration, cataract, very highly motivated to be free of glasses. So we put Symfony in both eyes, excellent results, very happy patient. And last one, in high myopic patients, I noticed that Symfony is a very good option. Why? Because of this IOL calculation, and because you have in high myopic patient, the status of the macula is not so perfect. With Symfony, which is not multifocal lens, but lens with one focus which is elongated, you can implant in even in macula which is not perfect. So this is lady, she is a teacher, high myop, minus 10 and minus 9, small cataract. I implanted Symfony in right eye, Symfony toric in left eye. She is very happy with distance, very happy with near vision. So for high myop, Symfony is very good option. So there is no perfect lens. There is no one lens for every patient. When you are doing refractive, when you are doing presbyopia correcting lenses, you have to sit with your patient to spend enough time for him to see what is his job, what is his hobby, does he drive a lot during the night, what are his expectations or her expectations. And then you have to make decision what kind of lens will you implant to this patient. Is it trifocal, is it bifocal, is it combination, is it Symfony or any other lens. So why we like Symfony? Because it has continuous vision from far to intermediate and pretty good for near, less halo, and it is more physiological compared to multifocal lens. And very important, very good and high contrast sensitivity, high quality of vision. So, just few minutes. This is something what is new, what will, as I mentioned, come to Ukraine in January or February next year. This is Synergy, Tecnis Symfony IOL. This is me again looking very happy again because we were among first three clinics in the world that implanted this lens in May this year. So what is Synergy? Synergy is lens, presbyopia correcting lens, which is combination of two technologies, of multifocal lenses and EDOF lenses. So it has multifocal technology, good distance and near visual acuity, and technology from Symfony, continuous visual acuity and chromatic aberration. Here you can see this defocus curve. This lens have good continuous vision from distance to near, up to 33 centimeters. Very high quality vision, very good contrast sensitivity, and very good visual acuity in dim light, in low light conditions. So if we compare Symfony, it has one focus elongated from distance to intermediate, or let's say to 50 centimeters. Synergy has from distance up to near, to 33 centimeters. So we could say this is elongated Symfony. But you will have opportunity to try it very soon. So please remember, there is no perfect lens. Each patient needs a special approach. Talk to him, ask to him what is he expecting, what are his daily activities, and then make decision which is the optimum lens for him. Never promise 100% spectacle independence. Always under promise and over deliver. Thank you very much for your attention.